안녕하세요. 저는 로렌스 윤입니다. Chief Economist with National Association of Realtors. 한국말 조금 서툴어서 영어로 합니다. 미안합니다. So, my name is Lawrence Yun. I am Chief Economist with NAR, which is a 1.5 million member association in America. And I want to thank Mr. Charlie Yi for allowing me to share some of my thoughts with you all. So, thank you very much. And congratulations in your gala. A large gathering of Korean American communities, New Jersey Korean Association of Realtors. So, a terrific leadership role by Mr. Charlie Yi. I met him in San Diego this past month at the National Association of Realtors annual conference, where we held in California, and there, Mr. Yi came and then we spoke and had a good discussion on many topics, topics about Koreans unable to come to America during this COVID period because of travel restrictions. But independent of the COVID, as you know, South Korea has been one of the bright stars for economic development. Just in 1950s, the World Bank, International Monetary Fund, they were all looking towards countries like Pakistan or Indonesia as potential growth in terms of economy. But it was the South Korea, our home country, where it really shined, providing example for the rest of the world as to how to grow. So we should all be very proud of that linkage. Now, because of such a strong economic growth that has occurred in South Korea, we are also beginning to see more Koreans moving, Korean Americans moving back to South Korea because the living standards are becoming almost very similar. But at the same time, we also continue to see many new immigrants from our home country into the United States. So the fact that the Korean American community in New Jersey, New York, Eastern part of America is growing fast, along with the California market, is a testament to the strength and the growing presence of the Korean American community. Mr. Yi asked me to talk about the area which I specialize in, which is economics and the real estate market. And during this pandemic in 2021 has been quite remarkable. Home sales rising to the best performance in 15 years. So the one positive aspect of this ugly situation of COVID, is that real estate has done very well. One of the key dynamics was people want larger size home. We are seeing it in the data. And they want single family housing, larger single family housing further away from the city. Office workers, Manhattan is the largest office space center in the whole world. Yet the many buildings are remaining empty because office workers were fortunately able to work from home and demonstrated that they can work from home. So even as the COVID situation dissipates, I think this new work from home flexibility will be part of the new economy, and hence the growth of the suburbs, the demand for larger space housing will continue even after COVID situation finishes. So going back, home sales best performance in 2020 and 2021 in 15 years. Last time we saw this high level of activity was back in 2006. Now, home prices are reaching all-time high with such a strength in home sales. And as we know, the inventory levels are just simply insufficient, not enough homes available for sale. So consequently, at the National Association of Realtors, myself, along with recent past president Charlie Oppler, who is from New Jersey, we have been adamant. We have been talking with the members of Congress, congressional staff, all the key policymakers in White House, at the Department of Housing and Urban Development, about how to stimulate more supply. We need more supply to make the market much more smooth functioning. The lack of supply has pushed up home prices and certainly good for homeowners, but we are beginning to see a decline in the number of first-time buyers. So the first-time buyers struggling to get into the market. Now, as we know in the Korean community, often it is the parents who help out their younger generation children with possible down payment to make the purchase. But this is leading to a somewhat of a divided situation where people who are in fortunate financial circumstances are able to get that help and make the home purchase, but other people who have to take out FHA loans or other mortgage product in a limited supply is becoming very, very difficult. Now, what's ahead in 2022? Well, for next year, mortgage rates will definitely be rising. We know that. Inflation is running high, and one way to contain inflation is to raise interest rates. And the Federal Reserve, the chairman, Jay Powell, has clearly communicated that they will taper, meaning buy less of mortgage-backed securities and raise short-term interest rates in 2022. The consequence of that policy is higher mortgage rates. Now, forecast is always difficult, and we will never get it perfectly correct, but one can be reasonable that it will be higher mortgage rates. I think it will be around 3.7% mortgage rate by end of 2022. So this time next year, 3.7% mortgage rate, that is my forecast. Current mortgage rate is right at around 3%. So it is higher, which means that in the early months of the spring, we may actually get a rush of buyers because they want to be ahead of the rising interest rate environment. So what's going to happen with higher mortgage rates as related to business activity? Well, first, for real estate practitioners who want to make those transactions, I think the sales will come down. We always see that. Higher interest rates bring down sales. Even with job creation, one can add jobs to the economy, but if the interest rate rises, it's going to cut back on home sales. So I expect that home sales could fall maybe 2-3% in 2022. But at the same time, for homeowners, because I think many of you in the audience are homeowners, Korean Americans have a high pride in the ownership. For home ownership, it is fine because home prices will continue to increase. Not the big increases of 10%, 15%, or 20%, but more modest 3, 4, 5% increase. Even as the sales are coming down, the rents are rising. And because of the rising rent, it provides some support for home prices. And also it raises the demand for real estate investor demand for real estate property. So we saw back in the 1980s, when the mortgage rates spiked upwards greatly, mortgage rate at one time was averaging 18%. Home sales came down, so it was difficult to do business. But home prices did not decline because of the increase in rents. And the rents are rising partly because of the increased jobs, but also many people who live with their parents. After losing job from the COVID, now they're returning and wanting to have their own apartment spaces. So the increased rental demand will support home prices. Going beyond 2022, 2023-2024 and beyond, what can we anticipate? First, work from home flexibility, I think, will be fairly a common feature of a new life, which means that commuting distances will be less important, but wanting to be along with other family members or say within the community. Maybe you see some Korean community looking at certain school district, and therefore they're gathering, looking to buy a home in certain neighborhood that is attached to the school district. Certainly Korean Americans, as we all know, place high importance on the education. So commuting to Manhattan becomes less important, while wanting to be with friends and family members or certain community, I think this is the new preference for home buyers. I want to thank Mr. Charlie Yee for giving me this opportunity to share my thoughts, and it was my pleasure talking to you, and at some future date, I really wish to meet you all in person. So congratulations on your gathering, and best to you all this year and upcoming next year. Thank you.